review in the GTP store. This GTP we created a year ago, ATAS. ATAS is a platform can help you to identify vulnerabilities, remedy vulnerabilities, training you based in your skill, give you the correct sequence of thinking about it. Currently, we have more of 60 people using ATAS. It was created for AppSec Incorporation, my business entity. We had different sections like AppSec, DevSecOps, Cloud Security, and the Security are the current section we have right now. We are going to implement another ones in the future, soon in the future. Well, in AppSec, he is going to scale you. For example, you choose or you may click in the button AppSec, you can see the introduction of that area in specific for cybersecurity. It's the same if you choose DevSecOps or under security or cloud security. He's going to give you information about it to start with this areas. For this exercise or this video, we are going to use an example I found in internet about code execution using the Ruby programming language. And now you can see we copy and paste and ATAS start to analyze the code. He's give you what is a breakdown about the vulnerability percent, what code lines you need to change, what is the potential exploit. The good thing is you have a very good subtitles and titles to identify the process. Other plus thing we have here is the fact, well, in that case, we are taking the code line or the section line with the vulnerability, and you can see he gives you the chains line, and he also gives you the comments about that is the way to use a safe HTTP request. And he's going to give you a summary for the implementation. From there, you can create the sect or testing, dynamic testing, to be used in Python or another code language. Well, the question was redundant, but the GTP is going to understand you. When I put DAST there, I am trying to say, is it dynamic application security testing? Give me a dynamic security, dynamic application security testing. You can see the way you can set up this in different tools. He mentioned how you can test this using Python, how can you test using Boolean or Canary tokens. You see? And he also gives you a summary about the spec tech outcome when you're testing this. When you send a request. And he also gives you recommendations about how you can configure the more famous tools in that area. For example, in the DAST market, you had a Bullswick open source or community edition you can use and download free for professionals. You can tap tool from OWASP. And you can also need to integrate this, for example, in the continuous integration and continuous delivery pipeline or Azure, the box, and he can give you the configurations of that tools for testing that DAST script or dynamic application security testing script we created before. The interesting part of this level, at the current level we had this GTP, is he gives you the recommendations by itself. That means after you terminate one process, for example, the first one was analyze the SAST tool, okay, analyze the code with vulnerabilities using SAST technology or static application security testing. He started to give you the step by step from the other testings and the other configuration tools you need to use. And that is great because he focuses in the more famous tools and the way he these ones need to configure. Here he showed you how you can use in the Docker OWASP ZAP. Run the Docker and run the test using core terminology. You see, he is thinking about AppSec because he is telling you you need to combine SAST plus DAST. Integrate this in the continuing integration, continuing delivery pipelines for automatic security testing. And now he offered by himself, Excel, sorry, give to us the payloads and the login mechanism to improve our testing. And also he mentioned tools like SIM, you can see. Is thinking how now integrate the SIM technology. The SIM technology is a technology for detection, intrusion in real time. And he's talking about how you can configure this technology also. He go back to the Canary Tokens URL to testing these payloads. And you see in the synced technology, he tried to mention the more common synced or more famous sim you can see in the market. And also technologies to receive alerts. Also, you can make that continuous integration and continuous delivery in the GitHub technology platform because GitHub is very solid about that. Now I am asking to it to create a modeling about the current problem we had with the source code in Ruby language, Ruby language, programming languages. Overview the vulnerability. It's going to give me first the attack vectors with the description. After you scroll down a little bit, you can see the stride type modeling. attack scenarios. For this video, I don't want to comment too much because the idea is you see all the level or the GTP currently have after 1 year of testing and training by myself. And it's beautiful. The table he displayed, you can see the colors, the summary he give you per section, no matter if SAS, DAST, configuration of the tools, or target modeling. It's very catching to the eye, or for the eye. And now he is crossing to the area of cloud security with the AWS signature validation by itself. You can see and this is all the areas ATAS is currently covered for. You can use it